From the moment the Lexus brand made its debut at the North American International Auto Show in Detroit 29 years ago, the LS sedan has been the division's flagship. But the luxury segment, just like the rest of the automobile market, increasingly is turning away from sedans and toward crossovers. So Lexus is testing the waters for what it dubs a new flagship luxury crossover with the debut of the LF-1 Limitless Concept at this year's Detroit Auto Show. What does a range-topping Lexus crossover look like? A lot like an Infiniti QX70, as it turns out. The proportions certainly mirror those of the crossover originally known as the FX, probably because, like the Infiniti, the Lexus uses a rear-drive architecture that allows for a long hood, a generous dash-to-axle ratio, and short front overhang. While the company mentions the concept's rear-drive roots, as for the engine, evidently that's where the word limitless comes in. Lexus shrugs and says it could have fuel cell, hybrid, plug-in hybrid, gasoline, or even all-electric power.Sizewise, the LF1 is considerably larger than the now-discontinued midsize Infiniti, 3.5 inches longer in wheelbase, 6.1 inches longer overall, more than 2 inches wider, and nearly 2 inches lower. The concept's flanks are smooth, with surfacing that is less busy than we've seen on production Lexus models lately. Up front, however, the spindle grille is taken to an even greater extreme. The centrally mounted Lexus logo appears to be exerting gravitational pull on all the fascia elements surrounding it, creating a cartoonish, painful-looking grimace. One can only hope it will be toned down for production. The other exterior oddity is the rear spoiler, which has a large gap in the center. In between, the liftgate glass appears to wrap up onto the roof. More conventionally, for a concept at least, the LF1 also features flush door handles, which reveal a Lexus logo when they pop out, and rides on 22-inch wheels. The LF1 is just a hair longer than the new three-row Lexus RX350L. But it has only 4 seats inside. All 4 chairs are the same high-backed, white-leather-upholstered buckets. In front of the driver there's a central instrument screen flanked by 2 side-view camera displays. Physical buttons and knobs are largely banished, naturally, with the vehicle instead responding to gesture controls and a touch-sensitive haptic panel on the center console. Rear seat riders have screens built into the front seatbacks and their own haptic panel. Dark brown leather, metal accents, and real wood dress up the interior. The wood door trim has tiny holes illuminated by LEDs in different colors. Autonomous driving capability, here called Chauffeur mode, is of course included. Human pilots can control vehicle speed with paddles alongside the steering wheel, and shifting ease via buttons on the wheel hub. For now, Lexus isn't saying whether a production version of the LF1 would replace the LS, be sold alongside it, or sit above it in the lineup. Should the LF1 reach showrooms, we'd say the arrival of a crossover flagship would mark the third biggest event in the brand's history, after the debuts of the RX, the longtime top seller, and the original LS400, all 3 of which were first seen at the Detroit Auto Show.